everybody, and welcome to the Rooster's Nest. My name is the Rooster, and every morning I go live right here on Bego and on YouTube to read to us all from this beautiful book called The Book of Awakening by Mark Nepo, so that we might all have some peace in our hearts to start our day, and so that we might be able to open our minds and our hearts a little bit more, you know, because the whole world is set up in such a weird way. We made it all up, you know, like what we are. We made it up starting from a really long time ago, and it all is effed up to the max. So we have to start with ourselves to make the world a better place, you know? Yeah. So we read from this book. Thank you very much for those thumbs up. And then we also pull a card from this deck called The Nature of Infinite Love and Gratitude by Dr. Darren R. Weissman. We pull one at random. It has an affirmation for us so that we can know what we need to know for today. And then I perform in some way. And today is Weird Wednesday. So you'll find out what I'm going to do. The song I'm going to sing is not like especially weird. It's just like kind of weird. I think it's a weird song. I like it. It's weird. So anyways, that's what we're going to do. Why don't we get started? Thank you so much again, follow up. You're real nice. Thanks for being here. All right. So it's November 3rd. Here we go. It says, In the care of something unseen. Genius is a crisis that joins the breed self for certain moments to our daily mind. Wow. Let's hear that one more time. Genius is a crisis that joins the buried self for certain moments to our daily mind. Wow. Oh, thanks for being a fan. It's so true. That was said by William Butler Yeats. Hi, son. We have been trained to think of genius as an unusual brilliance of mind, an ability to retain or calculate or conceptualize uncanny amounts of information. Yeah. Again, follow. Did I follow you? I can follow you. Sure, my friend. But the original sense of genius means attendant spirit, being in the care of something unseen, but near. Hold on a second. My webcam is a little bit too tall. Boop. There we go. Yeah. See, I've always felt like, you know, genius, what everybody thinks of as genius is not really true. And Nepo agrees. It is really another definition of wholeness or God, another way of acknowledging the Tao, the unseeable stream we all swim in. What Yeats offers us is an insight into life on earth. The great Irish poet suggests that crisis is an unexpected jarring of our ways that brings us into contact with our attendant spirit. I'm reminded that the Chinese ideogram for danger also means opportunity. What? Crazy. This is not to suggest that we seek out danger, but that we look for the openings when broken by experience, by which we can find our connection to the unseeable stream we often forget we are a part of. Perhaps the purpose in crisis, if there is one, is not to break us as much as to break open. Just like that quote by Leonard Cohen, I believe, that's something like, everything has a crack. That's how the light gets in. Beautiful. Yeah. Crisis, not to break us as much as to break us open. Hello, Jack. Hello, Arturo. Okay, so that was the passage, and now it's time for the meditation. So why don't we go ahead and do that? It says, sit quietly and feel the unseeable stream you are part of. Hello, William. Thanks for the taps, my dear. I don't know how to say your name. Thank you. Okay, so meditation, everybody. Are you ready for this? Let's get started on the meditation. Everybody sit quietly and feel the unseeable stream you are a part of. Breathe slowly and meditate on your genius, your attendant spirit. Breathe softly and expose whatever crisis you are in to your attendant spirit. Breathe softly and expose whatever crisis you are in to your attendant spirit. Thank you for the hearts. If you can, move through your day feeling both your crisis and the depth of your genius. Let them join. For we are all things all at once, and all we can do is surrender to it. Flow in the stream. Beautiful. Beautiful. I liked that. Good stuff. Okay, guys. So that was our Nepo book for the day. And now it is time for our card. We're going to pick one of these cards at random. What's it going to be today? What's going to be today? What do we got today? What's going to be today? What do we got today? Ooh, what's it going to be today? What you got for me today? Let's see. Oh, what's it gonna be today? Beautiful, guys. Look at it's a green heart on a green background, and it says growth. Love, both given and received, is the primary nutrient that feeds me and enables me to grow and adapt. Love! Both given and received is the primary nutrient that feeds me and enables me to grow and adapt. My heart and soul grow deeper in love. Your heart and soul are growing deeper in love as I embrace the contrasts of my life. Like I said, we're all of the things at all times. And all we can do is embrace these contrasts, these paradoxes, these yes ands, these no buts. That's why when that dingbat was asking me, was saying yes or no, I'm saying, no, it's not. Nothing is a yes or no. It's all a conversation. My heart and soul grow deeper in love as I embrace the contrast of my life. Number 23, which equals 5. Again, love, both given and received, is the primary nutrient that feeds me and enables me to grow and adapt. Love, guys. It's all about love. My heart and soul grow deeper in love as I embrace the contrast of my life. Oh, yeah, baby. Beautiful. Thank you, Dr. Darren R. Weissman. So filling. All right. So it's Weird Wednesday. Yeah, right? This deck. Check it out. It's a beautiful one. There's lots of lovely images. And that one was really nice. Okay. So I am doing Rocky Raccoon by the Beatles. because it's just kind of a little bit weird, and I'm just a little bit weird, you know? Maybe I'm a lot weird, and this song's just a little weird. Here we go. That love. Yeah. Yeah, it's the fabric of the universe, and it's the denial of love, and it's the absence of love that is destruction, is what rips apart. Wow. Okay, here we go.
Somewhere on the black mines of Coca-Cola, there lived a young boy named Rocket Raccoon. And one day his woman ran off with another guy. Hit young Rocket in the eye. Rocket didn't like that. He said, I'm going to get that boy. So one day he walked in and booked himself a room at the local saloon. Rocky Raccoon checked into his room. Only to find Gideon's Bible. Rocky had come equipped with a gun to shoot off the legs of his rival. His rival, it seems, had broken his dreams by shooting the girl of his fancy. Her name was McGill, but she called herself Lil. Everyone knew her as Nancy. Well, she and her man, who called himself Dan, were in the next room at the hoedown. A Rocky Kingston and grinning a grin. He said, Danny boy, this is a showdown. But Daniel was hot. He drew first and shot. And Rocky collapsed in the corner. Ah!
It's a hoedown.
The doctor came in, stinking a drink, and proceeded to lie on the table. He said, Rocky, you met your match. And Rocky said, Doc, it's only a scratch. And I'll be better, Doc, as soon as I am able. And now Rocky was cool. He fell back in his room, only to find Gideon's Bible. Gideon checked out and left it, no doubt, to help with Lord Rocky's revival. Oh, yeah, yeah.
It's Weird Wednesday, guys. Well, I don't know about you, but I had a great time. And that's the whole point, guys. You got to do what makes you feel good. Make yourself laugh. Everybody's out there looking all over the freaking internet all the time for things to make them laugh. Make yourself laugh. Have a good time, you know? That's the Rooster's philosophy. That's one of his philosophies. Be yourself. Out loud. Love. Always love. Love life. And, yeah, never give up. Pardon me. Thanks, everybody. Again, follow up. Thank you for being such an awesome presence in my live and everybody else who has tapped, commented, share. If you share next time, that would be really great. Love ya. Remember, you can never fail if you never give up. So don't give up. Just keep going. Number two. Number three is here. Hi. Number two. If you ever feel down, nope, that's number three. Number two, everyone is someone. So who are you? That is the journey. And number three, if you ever feel down, all you have to do is look in the mirror and say, she's a woman! And Ms. Cracker, this person right here, she'll be with you. Or, and you could say, and the rooster will be with you. Thanks, guys. See you again tomorrow, 9 a.m. Love you. Bye.